Your head gasket maintains all the different fluids in their proper channels by sitting between the engine's head and the combustion chamber. Despite its apparent simplicity, this part of the work is subjected to a lot of force and movement because of its proximity to the combustion chamber. A host of issues will arise if the seals begin to fail, which may result in additional engine damage. Although it may appear to be a straightforward part, it serves a vital purpose. In this extensive guide, we'll walk you through every step of testing for a blown head gasket. Check your exhaust. You may have a blown head gasket if you examine your exhaust and notice significantly more smoke than normal. When diagnosing excess exhaust, there are a few things to keep in mind. First of all, you should anticipate more smoke than in warmer months when the outside temperature drops. This does not suggest a burst head gasket, rather, it is completely normal. Second, since coolant burns this color if it enters the combustion chamber, you should be on the lookout for excessive white smoke if your head gasket has blown. Lastly, for the issue to be a burst head gasket, there must always be an abundance of smoke. It is probably not a blown head gasket if the amount of exhaust smoke varies after warming up or on different days. Check your engine oil. Checking your engine oil is one of the simplest and most reliable ways to find out if you have a blown head gasket. Although you can use the dipstick to check it, it is much more efficient to drain the oil from the pan and take a look if you're about to need an oil change. Coolant and engine oil mixed together is a sign of a burst head gasket. If your oil has a milky color rather than the typical brownish or black color of spent oil, you can tell that it's mixed. The color will be more milky the more coolant there is. Check your spark plugs. Coolant or oil on your spark plugs is a surefire sign that your head gasket has burst. Although it's more difficult to detect than when you check your oil or exhaust, this is a reliable method of diagnosing the issue. Just take out your spark plugs and give them a close inspection. You have a problem, most likely a blown head gasket, if you see any oil or coolant residue on the spark plug tip. Check your coolant. Since your coolant system is sealed, whatever you put in it ought to stay there. Furthermore, although variations in temperature and pressure can cause the levels to vary slightly, they should largely remain constant. Therefore, there's a good chance that coolant is going somewhere it shouldn't be inside your engine if you find that you need to keep adding coolant to the system even though there isn't a visible leak. Smoke from an overabundance of sources enters the combustion chamber, and oil with a milky hue enters the oil channels. In addition, if there is oil in the coolant reservoir, you will notice a frothy or milky color that indicates there is a problem, similar to how your oil can change color if it is combining with the coolant. Additionally, it may indicate that compression is entering the coolant system if smoke emerges from the coolant reservoir with the coolant cap off. An exhaust tester can also be used to test this. Check the radiator. When inspecting your radiator, you can check for a few different things. A blown head gasket will first allow air to enter the cooling system, resulting in a frothy or foamy mixture in the radiator. Furthermore, the system may be mixed with fuel and oil. If that occurs, the mixture you see when you check the radiator will be milky in color. Run a compression test. This is one of the trickier tests to administer, but it's also one of the most successful. To complete the task, you'll need a few specialized tools and will also need to remove the spark plugs. Make sure to examine the spark plugs after removing them to look for any signs of coolant or oil residue. If your head gasket bursts, you will observe a decrease in compression in the impacted combustion chamber. This is due to the fact that the cylinder can never completely seal, allowing extra pressure to escape. However, this method can make it very difficult to find small leaks. Check for leaks. It's common knowledge that a burst head gasket can cause fluids to leak outside of your engine, but less so that it can cause external leaks. The location of the leak is crucial. Fluid will drip down the outside of your engine rather than into separate passageways if it is closer to the head gasket. If your engine is pooling and burning off before it reaches the ground, this could cause smoke to come off of it. Alternatively, should it come in contact with the ground, fluid should start to pool underneath your car. The only method to identify this fluid as a faulty head gasket is to locate the source of the leak. It could be coolant or oil. You've identified your issue if you can determine that the head gasket is the source.